My name is Jacob Andreas. I work on natural language processing and language understanding, and I'm interested in basically anything that relates language to the real world or uses language as a tool for interacting with and understanding things in the real world. Right now I have students in my group working on instruction following, on robotic assistance, image editing interactively with language, and a lot of work on interpretability, on generating natural language explanations of decisions in machine learning models. So I guess one way of thinking about a lot of the work that I'm trying to do right now is that we sort of want to, everything that we can do with a programming language right now, I want to give people the ability to do with natural language as well. So anywhere you have some sort of complicated one-off task that requires a lot of automation or would be really difficult to do as a human, we as programmers have great tools for doing these kinds of things, but they're not accessible, they're things that require a lot of sort of training and highly specialized education, whereas we can communicate our goals and ideas very effectively to people using the languages that we already speak. This is something that everybody can do, and I would like that to be enough to make computers basically be able to do anything as well. So I guess I've always been, at least since the beginning of college, interested in artificial intelligence broadly, and language always felt like the piece of it that was kind of closest to deep problems about reasoning and understanding more generally. But I think I'm also interested in sort of questions of language science and why it is that natural languages look the way they do and the sorts of learning and predictive pressures that shape them the way they are. And so one of the things that's exciting about working in natural language processing right now is that you can do both these sort of very applied, very useful things and also think about deeper questions about how language works and why it works that way. So one project that I'm really excited about right now is using language to improve our ability to learn from demonstrations. So if I have some sort of household robot or personal assistant, I'm trying to teach it a new skill. The hope is that we can build agents that can learn more effectively and more sort of naturally from human feedback by giving them the ability to take guidance and to interpret other things that they've been shown in the form of language rather than having to rely on sort of raw demonstrations. And in the long term, you can imagine that this would be useful for things like personal household robotics or various other kinds of personal assistants, where people are constantly wanting to teach them new skills and giving them new ways of interacting with the world. So the things that I'm doing right now apply most directly, I think, to personal computing in the sense that, you know, when people are working on their computers already, there's a lot of tasks that they might want to automate or do more effectively and aren't able to do right now. But in the long term, you know, these same kinds of technologies are, again, extremely applicable to things like household robotics and self-driving cars and, customer support. There's a whole kind of universe of things that we might like to be able to automate and give people more effective information in the form of language, building better search engines. So, you know, I think really anywhere people are interacting with computers and where there isn't already a specialized interface for doing it, we can do that more effectively with language. This is a really exciting time to be working in, I guess, natural language processing or in machine learning and applied areas of machine learning more broadly. That there's been this kind of convergence of tools that everybody's using, and with this, it's become suddenly much easier for us to sort of build language processing models that interact with models in robotics and models in computer vision and in really any other area that you can imagine. And so, you know, I think really sort of fundamentally what I'm trying to do in my group is figure out what the implications of this are, both for NLP and for machine learning more broadly. So what are the new sort of ways in which we can think about language understanding problems, the new ways in which we can use language as an interface to interact with the world in all kinds of different ways, but also what does it mean for machine learning more broadly, and what can we do with language data in support of all of these other artificial intelligence applications that are out there. And if you have more questions, you can contact me at jda@mit.edu.